The year and a half since my retirement has been a wonderful period of introspection, an opportunity to reflect on my career. Looking back, I'm certain that cricket has made me a better, more well-rounded person. It certainly gave me the opportunity to mature personally and the platform to experience both success and failure, learn from them and accept them both as part of life. I'm often asked for advice on how to be successful. Honestly, there are a million ways to be successful, and I'm nobody to tell you which one is right for you. Each one of us has to find our own path. I'd like you to picture a boy born in a typical middle-class family. I was that boy. What made us somewhat different was that my uncle played alongside C.K. Naidu for the Holkar team, and my dad represented his university team, and he was completely cricket crazy. The radio commentary was always on at home during test matches, and my father followed every single match with the international or the domestic. He took me and my brother along the stadiums to watch the greats in action at every possible opportunity. To his mind, there was no better use of our time. Like any young boy, I hero worshipped my father, and my curiosity about this game that he was so passionate about grew progressively deeper. As I spent more time watching the game with him and playing it in my backyard and on the street, my curiosity gave way to interest. And before long, this interest gave way to love. The seed had been sown. I remember at some point in those early years, feeling like I knew deep inside me what I had been born to do. I learned that sometimes inspiration just stares you in the face. When I am requested to speak to youngsters, I like talking about this phase of my life and liken it to the fascinating plant, the Chinese bamboo. You can take a Chinese bamboo seed and plant it in the ground. Water and nurture the seed for an entire year and not even see a single sprout. In fact, you will not see a sprout for 5 years. But suddenly, finally, a tiny shoot will spring from the ground. And over the next 6 weeks, the plant can grow as tall as 90 feet. It can grow as fast as 39 inches every 24 hours. You can literally watch the plant grow. What was the plant doing during these 5 years seemingly dormant period? It was growing its roots. For five full years, it was preparing itself for rapid, massive growth. Without this root structure, the plant simply could not support itself for its future growth. Some would say the plant grew 90 feet in 6 weeks. I would say it grew 90 feet in 5 years and 6 weeks. This period tested my faith and willingness to believe in my own talent at the beginning of my journey. I even captained the Indian under-19 team. Question I got wherever I went was, when are you going to play for the country? Now, this is not something that I had any control over, but the question began to dominate my life and my being. Even when it wasn't asked, it was the elephant in the room. I ended up playing 5 years of domestic cricket before getting my national break. It was frustrating. I remember putting a sticker on my kinetic Honda, which read, "God's delays are not God's denials."
I'd made a pact with myself that that I wouldn't cry. I think it's being tested to the limit today. It doesn't feel like I've retired in some ways. You know, I've had a chance, you know, over these last 3 weeks to try and think about what playing for India meant to me. What was this dream, and what has it meant to me? What has it given me? But I think, you know, and sometimes the people who achieve great things, of course, they do it through dint of hard work and sacrifice, but they're also very lucky. I played with a lot of people who, if you go down the record books of Indian history of Indian cricket, probably will not be considered great, at least statistically. But in my eyes, everyone who played the game with me and played it with an intention to win, with a desire to win, and gave it everything, was a hero. And I learned so much from you. It was inspiring to watch people work so hard and struggle so much and sometimes not achieve what they want and come back and do it again and again. I may not be playing for India anymore, but to the present Indian team, what I'd like to say is that, guys, I will watch with great interest what I think is an extremely exciting and really talented group of young cricketers. All I can say is that I hope Indian cricket will always be a strong force, both on the field and off the field. And I have no doubt that I will take great pleasure with a cup of tea and a biscuit in my hand, watching you guys achieve great things.